hospital pharmacy, all the medicine I had, there was nothing we could do with those days, Mark. It was just, I had, as part of the pharmacy in the hospital, was a cancer unit, where we were testing drugs on people, chemotherapeutic agents that never worked. So I had kind of that pressure, knowing that anything we were doing wasn't working, and the prospect of having 3 months of life left to my daughter. So we took her down to Children's Hospital in Los Angeles, and it was fortunate enough that her name popped out of a database at St. Jude's Hospital in Memphis that was targeting a seven-year-old white female that they were going to do this particular test, a drug protocol on. So we tried the test, and while we were doing it, I remember, and even though I was hopeful and prayerful, as you can imagine, that it'd be successful, that I promised God, that the Lord, that if you saw this through, made her healthy, that I would dedicate my life to making others healthy. That was when pharmacy was changing, and we were moving from a kind of an outcomes-based medical world without all the drugs that you have today, without a lot of chronic disease. We were using a lot of natural medicine, botanicals, what we call pharmacognosy. So there's a lot of natural medicine going on in those days, but things kind of moved forward, where today we're kind of, the medical world has changed, where it's really treatment-oriented. We're really good at using antibiotics for infections. We're really good at trauma and treating people, but not for chronic disease. So at that point, and I'm going to tell it here because sometimes I forget, that Stephanie is alive and well today. So with that, the dedication that I committed myself to study vitamins, natural products, to really help improve outcomes, improve health, instead of just treating and suppressing symptoms.
So you were in the pharmaceutical world, so you had to go to nutraceutics in order to actually try to help people.
That's right.
Okay, I thought so. All right, so one of the other things that the assessment does, and I want to kind of jump into here, is it actually tells people why they are actually being recommended what they're being recommended, and sometimes that why is lost. I want you to talk briefly about the importance of the why and why that button's there.
Well, whenever we're proud of our research, and we think that as part of people believing in what they're doing, being consistent, and patient compliance is so important. But if you know why the product is being, this research is being presented, how applicable it might be to your particular situation, we're not only showing the why, but we're giving the science behind it. So we believe it's important to educate people, because if you believe in what you're taking is right for you, and you understand that it's documented in the scientific and medical literature, then you're going to feel more strong about it. And the patient compliance that you need, taking nutrition is every dose, every day, every week, every year.
And as you can see, you know, not only do you get what it is and what's in it, but you also get the answer that you provided and the reason why it's being given to you based upon that answer. And then, of course, it's giving you the science. And one of the things that we talk about all the time, and this issue is sometimes lost when we talk about ID Nutrition. ID Life isn't the one that's actually making the recommendation. See, it's the science that made the recommendation. It's just ID Life that took the time to build exactly what the science told us to build. And I think that's an important differentiation.
It is. Also the fact that you accept the evidence as is, that when you look at it, I have the option to read the evidence, you can share it with your doctor to validate and ask, when he asks you why your health is transformed because you've been on this program, what are you doing? You know, the fact that your blood pressure might be going down or blood sugar is improving, that you can present the evidence to them that this is really research that's in the medical literature, and it's worth following, and you're living the effects of it.
You know, one of the things I want to make sure that we also show is, you know, you guys, do you like the new design of the new assessment? Isn't that beautiful? Well, I wanted to show you one thing that is in development, and I'm going to have Paul talk about it briefly. If you notice, one of the things is you're actually now going to be able to see this info button on your lifestyle products. And when you hit the info button, what you're going to do is you're actually going to get some information about the product. So very much like the why button, you're going to have the ability to actually get information on the product that is recommended to you. But let me tell you about something, because as you see up there in that subtitle, it says version 2.0 in the why. What is in the works right now is we're going to replace the info with a why button. And when you hit the why button, what it's going to do is it's not going to tell you what it is. It's going to tell you the answer you provided and why you need it. That's what's coming. Now, let's talk about the importance of this, because I don't want to be lost how much work this is actually going to take in order to take lifestyle products and actually give the reason why.
Giving the answers like this, the research that we're going to have to do, implementing some of these retail products into the attaching on the end of the assessment is beautiful in that if you have sleep problems, energy problems, that it's going to recommend an appropriate product if it's safe for you. So we're going to be spending 2 months at least researching the more than 3,000 drugs we have in the database to go back and look at every ingredient. And make sure, just like the ID Nutrition Program, your vitamins do not interact with any drugs or negatively impacting any medical condition, and be able to make sure that it's just as safe as the medication or as a vitamin program you're getting. So, huge amount of work to go back through every ingredient and every product to kind of back engineer it to make sure that everyone is safe.
Only 2.7 million outcomes. Don't worry, we'll have it done in a little bit. The other thing is, we talked yesterday about a commitment, and I don't want this to be lost, and we can never say this enough. You know, ID Nutrition is constantly evolving. It is a living, breathing thing. It truly is. And our commitment is to never be satisfied with where it is and always strive to make it better. And Paul, I want you to talk briefly about that, because, I mean, we make changes sometimes that are well ahead of what, we already have the best out there, and sometimes we're like, you know what, we can make it better, so let's go and make that change now. So let's talk about that.
It is, and the one example here is my bad. The first one is spirulina. And we have been bothered that spirulina is effective AM and PM. But in the PM, it's real effective for asthma, allergies, upper respiratory problems. And because the old program had, the old formulation had green tea in it, which is a really powerful antioxidant, but we couldn't find enough, get a brand that we